He's a historian. I'm just an amateur historian. And now he's the Deputy Prime Minister of Poland. And we've had a very interesting conversation that I wanted to share in part with our audience, because I thought it was very substantive, very candid. It addressed some of the important issues between the world Jewish community in Israel and Poland. Now, Mr. Deputy Prime Minister, you were telling me that Poland today is Israel's foremost ally in Europe. Is that how your government feels?
This is what we deeply believe in, that the Polish-Israeli relationship are very important for in the wider context, in for the peace in Middle East, for peaceful relationships in Europe as well. And of course, we are very good friends to the Israeli state, but also we are very good friends for all the Jewish communities all around the world. We feel that we are actually obliged to rebuild good history between Poles and Jews, which was so brutally and dramatically stopped on this day 78 years ago, and the history was developing for several hundred years. So it's important for me not only to understand the history of what has happened before and during the Second World War between our nations, and what Germans did to Jews and to Poles, and they have changed the history of Jews, and they have completely eliminated Polish Jewish nation from Earth, but they have also completely changed the history of Poland during the Second World War and because of the communism thereafter. But today we have to also think about how to deal with some prejudice and some thinking about our relationship, which is not really in line with what has happened, and we have to build as many connections between the Jewish nation here in America and the Jewish nation
and the Polish people
and the Polish people.
Well, you and I had an amazing conversation, and I hope that we can bring the conversation to the public at some point. But what we touched on was this, essentially, that there is still a strong residual resentment on the part of many in the Jewish community towards the Polish people, in that they feel that the Polish people were involved in some way in the Holocaust. And your response to me essentially was that not only do the Polish people feel that that is unfair and untrue, but that the Holocaust was a German phenomenon visited upon the Jewish people in Poland, and the Polish people suffered tremendously as well. So why are the Polish people being held accountable? And you feel that there are people in Poland who are confused as to why there'd be any kind of hostility. Is that a fair assessment? That's a fair summation. And my response to that was that a lot of Jews looked at Polish Jewish history and they said, well, there was a history of pogroms and a history of anti-Semitism. And I think your response was there was also a history of a flourishing community that was invited
more,
in.
And much more of this.
Of a flourishing community.
Of the flourishing.
And you feel that story has not been told sufficiently.
Not been told, and we have a fantastic museum, Pauline, in Warsaw.
It is a fantastic museum.
Yes, yeah, to which everybody is invited, of course. And this tells the story of several hundred years of living together in a very peaceful combination, which has never happened anywhere in other countries in Europe. And from all the other countries, Jews were expelled every now and again, and this has not happened in Poland virtually. And eventually what happened during the Second World War changed completely everything, and because of the German narrative post-war, now many people think that maybe this is Nazis from cosmos, from the space, who came and who changed this.
So you feel there's an ongoing German narrative even today?
Oh, absolutely. So in the German press, Germany was not
responsible for the Holocaust. It was the Nazis.
It was
almost
the Nazis,
a small segment,
plus the Polish concentration camps, as if Poland existed during the Second. Not only did not exist, but this has suffered alongside the Jewish nation.
So Poland takes great exception, perhaps even offense by that terminology, Polish
huge
concentration
offense,
camps?
Huge offense. I think it's so
you think they should be called German concentration camps?
Of course, but because they were German concentration camps, yes.
Do you feel that the... So, we were talking about how do we get past this? Jews come in large number today to Poland, but not to see a thriving Jewish community in Poland or to see a thriving Polish nation. They come to see a giant Jewish cemetery, which is Treblinka, Auschwitz-Birkenau, Majdanek, etc. How do we change it? How do we forge a new future of Jews looking to Poland as a place where many of their ancestors are from, where there was hundreds of years of Jewish history, which produced some of history's greatest Jewish scholars?
Yeah.
Is your government interested in building that future with
our
the Jewish
government
people?
Is extremely interested in building this second dimension, this second leg, because the first dimension is extremely important. That this has to be continued. Of course, all the places, Belzec, Sobibór, and the others, they have to be visited, and there has to be this has to be always present in our hearts and minds forever. But also I think that we have to develop our relationships for the future, and there is a Jewish festival for culture, and there are in many small even towns and in other cities than Krakow and Warsaw, there are Jewish events, the Jewish festivals, which are very popular in Poland. And I'd like to invite everybody, every Jew and every American from here, from the United States, to Poland, because this can create a much better climate for us talking about history, but also us concentrating about on the future and how to create a better world for everybody.
So, Mr. Deputy Prime Minister, I mean no offense, believe me, and I've been very impressed with this of our meeting, and I look forward to getting to know you better. I'm very grateful to Johnny for introducing us. But how would you respond? And I've apologized ahead of time to say the famous quotation from one of the Israeli prime ministers, Yitzhak Shamir, that the Polish people drinking anti-Semitism from their mother's breast. Is that an accurate quotation? How would you respond to something like that?
I would bring all the facts and figures and all the hundreds of years of our history to falsify this, to show that this is complete nonsense. And in every nation there are good people and bad people. It was very unfortunate that during the Second World War and before that, in the German nation there were so many bad people. Probably the majority of all the people were bad people. But in Poland we have lots of interest in Jewish culture, in Polish Jewish culture. There was a language which was no longer in existence, and my friends are trying to learn this language. I mean Yiddish.
And there's a resurgence of interest in the Jewish community on the part of non-Jews in Poland. I saw it myself. I saw 10,000 non-Jews in Krakow at the Polish Jewish Festival, and I spoke there.
Exactly.
So you think you feel not only is it not true, but it's unfair. That characterization.
Yeah, that's
you think that you think unfair. It offends the Polish people.
It does, absolutely, yes.
And that the Polish people today are very interested in a friendship, being strong allies of Israel, and friendship with the Jewish community globally.
Strong allies of Israel, strong allies of the United States, one of only five countries of NATO which spends more than 2 percentage points of GDP on military spendings, and one country which is stable, strong, free, but also wants to look for very good relationship around us and with Jewish community here in the United States. We would like to find a common ground both on history and on future.
Well, I was at President Trump's speech in Warsaw. I was very impressed that the president was there. I was honored to be a part of it, because after seeing all the horrors that were visited by the Einsatzgruppen and the German army and the Nazis on the Jewish people, to see the President of the United States, leader of the free world, suddenly arrive in your country was it gave us a feeling of thank God there's a close friendship there. Let me just finally say, I visited Poland recently. I went to places that were very painful for the Jewish community. I will absolutely say that we were treated with warmth and friendship by all the Polish citizens we encountered. At the Polish Jewish Festival, we encountered thousands of people who want to know so much about this almost vanished nation that was once such an integral part of Jewish history. And I do hope that we will forge far stronger ties, deeper friendship with the American Jewish community, Israel. I think that you can be a very important bridge. I think that you're a man of eloquence, and I think that you have great candor in being prepared to address some of these difficult issues that we often sweep under the rug. And I thank you for this conversation. And I wish you a safe trip back to Poland, and I look forward to visiting you in your country again. And since my grandfather's from Łomża, I look forward to getting to know so much more about our own roots in Poland, God willing. Thank you, Mr.
Thank you very much.
And God bless you. Thank you.